Hey everyone and welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going to be going over the origin, the insertion and the action of the deltoid muscle. The deltoid muscle is comprised of three heads. Here we can see highlighted the anterior head, here's the lateral head, and here's the posterior head. One thing to note about the lateral head is that for some reason it's mistakenly called the medial head of the deltoid by some people. Now, there's nothing medial about the lateral head of the deltoid because it is the most lateral head. It couldn't be any more lateral. Medial means towards the midline. So try not to make that mistake if someone has taught it to you incorrectly. So let's go over the origin next. So we can see the origin of the anterior head here on the lateral third of the clavicle. You can see the origin of the lateral head here on the acromion. And we can see the origin of the posterior head here on the spine of the scapula. All three of the heads are deltoid, are going to come together and form a common insertion here on the deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. The deltoid tuberosity of the humerus is going to be a slightly raised bump, which is in this blue area, which I've got highlighted right here. So we're back here again with a skeletal model, and you can see the deltoid muscle originating on the spine of the scapula, coming around to the acromion, to the lateral third of the clavicle, and then inserting on the deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. So let's go over the actions of the deltoid next. Now, the action is going to depend on which head is contracting. So let's start with the anterior head. And if you can imagine it's coming down here and you've got a contraction, it's going to cause flexion of the shoulder. So we've got flexion of the shoulder. It's the first action. And in addition to flexion, the anterior head can also internally rotate the humerus as well. So we got the humerus in an externally rotated position right now. That anterior head's contracting. There we go, internal rotation. So next let's take a look at the lateral head. So lateral head's coming down across here. And you can imagine as it squeezes, it's gonna cause abduction of the humerus. So we got abduction for that lateral head. Let's take a look at the posterior head, coming down here, got that squeezing, going to have extension of the humerus next. So we've got extension, just like that. And as well, similar to the anterior head, when the posterior fibers contract, they can actually cause external rotation of the humerus. So that's going to be the opposite of what the anterior fibers are doing. So we got internal rotator position here. Those posterior fibers have contracted and now it's externally rotated. So that covers the actions and the origin, the insertion of the deltoid muscle. If you enjoyed the video, you know which buttons to press. Thank you very much for watching. I'll see you all next time.